know the way that you think about me. But I don't wanna know the truth. I hear the things that they say about me. But I don't wanna know the truth. Don't you ever wanna run away? Don't you ever wanna walk away? Don't you ever wanna leave this place? 'Cause I need you when the day's gone. And I would change for you. I would break, I break these walls too. And I would change just for you. And I would change for you. And I would break, I break these walls too. I would change just for you. I can't get you out of my mind.
Hey guys, it's Fantasia, and welcome to the Foster Family Season 4, Part 1. I feel like I can't even get my words out because I'm so excited. Like, you guys have no idea how excited, and it's even a day late, so you can just, like, see my excitement. Just, it really, like, oh, I couldn't wait to just record it because I tried to, it didn't work out, and yeah, I explained that in a makeover video that I posted yesterday, and yeah, that's why it's a day late, but I explain all that about why and things like that, so yeah. Anyways, this is going to work out so much better this time, so I'm really happy, that I decided to do it Sunday instead. Otherwise, I don't think it would have been how I wanted it to be. So, of course, like always, in the beginning of a new season, I always do a rundown, so we'll be doing that. Just for any new viewers, or just, like, to refresh your memory, and I really just like doing this because there's, like, so much to it, but I have it all, like, really shortened down, so this is not, like, taking 3 years. So, as you guys can see, we have Allie and Molly. So, everyone knew I was starting with Allie, but you guys didn't know for sure who else was going to be living with her, and I decided on Molly because I'm really into her little story right now, and I really think it's going to add a lot, and I feel like they're the two perfect Sims to live together. Allie is kind of, she's gonna become very close with Serenity. I just see them clicking very well. So, like, you know, Molly, she'll get close with Molly too because now she lives with her. But I just feel like, I don't know, if Serenity was already an adult, I really don't think Allie and Serenity would ever live together still. I see Allie living with Molly. And I don't know, just for so many reasons, because I feel like Allie just is a very good motivator for Molly, and just really good for Molly. And then I feel like Molly is very, like, chill to live with. So yeah, we are gonna go ahead and get into the little rundown first, and then we'll get into Allie and Molly's little story. So this is gonna be quick, so, you know, if you haven't watched the past seasons, this will help you understand what happened before, but it's not going to be everything that happened. It's going to be very brief. So I'm just, like, telling you guys. Of course, okay, first of all, we'll do Allie's little thing. So Allie has, technically, the Fosters are not her blood family. She has their last name now because Destiny took her in. So basically she has, like, custody over her, but her real father is Lucas, and, Lucas got abducted by aliens, and this alien got him pregnant, and then we had Allie. Anyways, we are gonna actually look at, like, the whole family tree. So we're gonna start from the beginning here. So this is Macy. This is who I started with, and I don't know if you guys just saw that, but she, like, if I go back here, she ended up marrying a guy named Derek Fields, but that wasn't always who she was with. So in the beginning, she was with Don Lothario, and she had one daughter named Ava, and it didn't work out with them, you know? She kind of got pregnant early on, and she really, like, didn't want to be with Don forever, and there was some drama and stuff going on. They broke up, and then she found Derek, and she had three more children. So she had Chloe and Hazel. Hazel was the oldest, and then came Chloe, and then they adopted Landon together. So Landon was the youngest, he's adopted, and yeah, so that was kind of her little generation. And then Ava had a son named Randall, who was also now passed away because she was the oldest daughter, so he came pretty early. And yeah, so there's that. And then now we're gonna go into Hazel. So Hazel, she is it not showing me? Okay, yes it is. Oh my gosh. Okay, her family tree is smaller, so that just confused me. She was with a guy named Dominic for quite a long time, and she thought he was perfect for her, but it really, things went downhill. There was a lot of drama. It was not a good time. If you want to know about that, you guys can watch season 2 if you haven't. But if you watched it, then you know exactly what happened. There was a lot of drama going on with Dominic. And then she got with a guy named Quentin, who was an alien, and thought that he was in love with her and everything was going to go good. And, you know, they were going strong. But then found out that he basically had, like, a plan to have the aliens abduct Dustin. And then Dustin got abducted by aliens, but he didn't get pregnant from them. And ever since then, he was like, Quentin was like a big enemy for the whole family. Everyone hated him, you know. And then once again, Hazel broke up with him. And then she never really found anyone else, but she was happy with herself at this point. So there was kind of her story. She had one son, like I said, Dustin. And then we have, where is she? Over here. Then we have Chloe. Chloe basically was high school sweethearts with Jordan. It's not showing you guys Jordan. I'm not going to worry about that, but there's a guy named Jordan. They were together for the longest time. They were the cutest couple ever, literally perfect together. And she had 3 children with him. So she had Daniel and Destiny, which are twins. Destiny should be an elder. I don't know what's up with that, but they are twins. And then had Demi. That was her youngest daughter. And now we're going to go into... Okay, we'll go into Landon. So Landon, I'm not really going to go into. As you guys can see, I don't even really know what he did in life. I don't think he was with anyone. I didn't pay attention to him much because there was like so many other people in the household. So, but there's Landon. and then back to Chloe. So we'll go into Chloe's kids now. So we have Daniel, and then he met Elsa when Elsa was a child, and they have just been together ever since. They're perfect together. They are adorable, and they're still just so in love. And Elsa will be an elder soon. Daniel is an elder now. And then they had 2 beautiful children. I love them, named Serenity and Xander. So Serenity is the oldest, and they're both in high school. And then Xander, well, okay, Serenity is very girly. She likes girly things. She loves to do her makeup. She's at her makeup vanity. She's very girly. That's just her thing. And she really gets along with Allie very well. And then Xander is, he loves video games. He recently just turned, aged up to a teenager. He loves video games. And, he's pretty much obsessed with girls right now. I kind of like made a little more of a story for season 4, but yeah, he's very much into the girls right now. He actually has some braces and I gave him braces because of the new update for toddlers. We got more teeth options and we got braces. So yeah, he's just very into the ladies, and I see him having a lot of girlfriends, and yeah, he just loves his video games, and he's definitely a daddy's boy for sure. So there's their children. And now moving on to Destiny. So Destiny, obviously she had Allie and Harmony, but Allie is not her blood child. I just told you guys that story, so you know, she took her in, so it's not going to show her here. But then she had Harmony with Lucas as well. And Harmony grew up, like, she's not doing well in school. She's very to herself. She likes to do her own thing. She loves photography, and she's a very simple kind of girl. And yeah, she had a very tough life as a child because everything was going on when she was just a kid, like the breaking up and all of that, and she never really saw her dad much, so that was hard. But overall, now she's a lot happier, you know. Destiny got with a guy named James, which he's not going to show right now because they're not married or anything yet, but she's with a guy named James now. And then she had 2 more kids, Clarity and Chase. She had twins, and it was so unexpected, and she was really nervous at first. They were broke, and then they ended up winning the lottery, so that helped them out so, so much, and that was amazing for them. So yeah, that's kind of about them. I'm not going to go into them much. They're still young. They're twins. They love to play together, you know. They're pretty opposite, but they share the same room, but they get along, but they're just... they wish they could have their own room. They really don't really enjoy sharing. So there's them. And yeah, I'm pretty sure that's kind of all I have to explain to you guys as far as, well, let's do Demi. There's not too much with Demi, so I was like, you know, because you guys probably know. So okay, I'll say it just in case. So there's just a lot of talking, and I'm trying to cut it down short, but it's still a lot to say. You know, this is 4 seasons. It's a lot. So Demi is, she is lesbian, and she is with Izzy, which is not going to show here because they're engaged. They're not married yet. But yeah, she's engaged to Demi, and they've been together for a very long time, ever since teenagers. They're so cute. And yeah, they had a son together named Darius, and yeah, he is He's close with Xander. They get along really well, but they're very opposite. But they do get along really, really well, and that's like his best friend and one of his only friends. He doesn't really like to make friends at school. He honestly is not really into getting relationships just yet, but he's also questioning his, like, he doesn't know what he wants in life. So he is thinking he's bisexual, and he doesn't really know how he feels about that. So it's kind of, it's like a very confusing situation for him. He just staged up, you know, and honestly, he looks like the youngest teenager I've had so far. He looks like he's just like 14 years old. He looks so little. And yeah, he just kind of keeps to himself in his room and then just hangs out with Xander. They talk all the time. They're really close. And I feel like Darius feels comfortable to tell Xander things that he doesn't really tell anyone else. They're cousins, by the way. And yeah, so that's pretty much it for the whole family tree. I know that was like 10 minutes, but trust me, it was worse. The last time I talked about it, it was all jumbled. So that was like more to the point, but still, 10 minutes talking, that's a lot. So now this last part is really quick for you guys. So, because you guys pretty much already know because of the makeovers. So this is really quick to explain to you guys. If you haven't seen the makeovers, definitely check those out, because in Allie's makeover and Molly's family makeover, I definitely explain more about like their story. So, yeah, to start off season four, we're starting with Allie and Molly, as you guys know. And Allie is super excited to have her first apartment. They live in an apartment, by the way. They're in San Myshino. And yeah, she's just so excited to see where life takes her. And she is obsessed with let me show you. This guy right here. They are not together yet, but he does have the key to her apartment. They're lovebirds. She's obsessed with him. It's gonna be her soon-to-be boyfriend. She literally has the biggest crush on him ever, and she like just can't wait to see how they do together and everything like that. And she is actually in the social media career because she's gonna be a beauty guru. Someone suggested that because she's an alien and she does such a big drastic makeover. So she's in the social media career, but it's just for the fact that she's a beauty guru. But like, we can't do that, so you know. Yeah, and she loves to paint. She is good, romantic, creative, and muser. And yeah, she loves to paint. She's gonna be doing painting. She's gonna be doing social media things. So there is her. And then Molly, she is struggling with body confidence a lot. I talked about this already in the makeover. So if you wanna hear more, again, go watch that. It's in more in detail. And yeah, she wants to be like, she just wants to feel better about herself. She wants to work on herself, and she is happy that she's on her own now. She's happy to be living with Allie, and she doesn't want a boyfriend right now. She wants to focus on herself. She wants to love herself before she loves someone else. So yeah, and then she loves reading and writing, and she's in the writer career. Oh, you just saw that. So there is the two girls. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the walls down, and we're gonna get some gameplay in. So yeah, that was a lot of talking, but I feel like it was a lot more to the point compared to before. Before it was like I was leaving so much stuff out. It was, yeah, it definitely needed to be redone. And I know that was a lot to take in. It kind of reminds me of like 16 and Pregnant, the first part, how much talking that was. But I mean, this one is more of just there's a lot to go over. So yeah, and I hope you guys like the new intro. It is shorter, and that's just because I feel like it's better that way, because I change the intro so often, or the theme song, because, oh, also their apartment, let's address that. So, but yeah, I change the theme song so often, so I just thought it'd be better to make it shorter, because I have to change it up so much. All right, so this is their apartment. I did refurnish it. They are not fully moved in yet. They have air mattresses. They basically sold their room furniture in their previous houses, because their parents allowed them to sell. Like, so Allie sold everything that was in her room to get some extra money. They moved into this apartment, and they didn't really have much furniture and stuff, so they went and bought some air mattresses. There's some stuff in boxes. They both found these night tables, and they were just like, yep, let's grab them. And then there's just stuff everywhere. They're not done unpacking yet, you know? There's pots and pans, lots of stuff in boxes. So this is going to be obviously changing as each part goes on. They'll kind of move in more and more, and it'll eventually be all furnished. But I thought I would do it this way. And then clearly, Allie picked the wallpaper for this room. They painted, and she definitely painted these two rooms. She loves the bright colors, and she picked out the couches. So yeah, and then, you know, they got nail polish on here because there's nowhere to put it right now. And then they found this cheap TV at the flea market, and Not really, but we're just saying that. And yeah, it was a good size and it was cheap, so they grabbed it. And then, you know, Allie has the stuff all over her room. Then we have their little office area, which, you know, I needed a bookcase for Molly, and we need a computer, of course, for both of them, actually. And more boxes, more stuff over here. Then we have their balcony, and I just put an easel here in two little pots because I thought maybe they could plant some plants. And Allie loves painting, so there we go. I think she can actually sell this one now. So we're gonna go ahead and sell that. Also, I really hope any of you guys who don't like a bunch of talking in a short amount of time with no gameplay, I really hope you guys skipped through that. But I mean, there's no way around it. Like, I had to do that. Okay. So, yeah, she's actually playing games, but you know what she's gonna do? We're gonna have her practice writing, I think. I don't know if she has the writing skill. So, okay, yeah, she just got it. So, yeah, she's gonna be doing that so that she can improve her writing. So here we go, acquire the writing skill. And then, what's wrong with you? Their neighbors came over and I had to start the part after that because I was getting things ready and they left some fruitcake. They're not happy with it. Nope. Also, because she is at home, I am going to go ahead and remove her disguise. Because if you guys don't know, Allie only takes off her disguise when she's at home. When she's out anywhere, she keeps it on. She only feels comfortable in her own house without the disguise. Okay, she needs the bathroom. Why can't I click this? There we go. Also, the kitchen is the same. I just changed it all to black because I felt like it looked a little better. Oh. Is Dylan coming over or something? Yay, he's here for the first part. Oh my gosh, you guys. Ooh, she feels awkward. Wait, this is all part of the story. Disguise herself. I mean, I think he knows. Yeah, he did find out. But she doesn't feel comfortable with him seeing her like that yet. You know what I mean? Because they're not even together yet. She just had her first kiss with him not long ago. She met him at the prom. Yes, he still needs his makeover. I know. You know what I'll do for you guys right now, though? We will go ahead. Actually, can I even do it right now? Let me go ahead. I really want to do this. I'm going to go ahead and give him his glasses. So he's not going to have his makeover yet, just because that's like the one thing I didn't have time to do. Everyone got their makeovers except for Dylan. So yeah, in the next part, he'll have his makeover. But for right now, we'll give him his glasses because I know you guys want that. And that was like something you guys were like so happy about. So yeah, dang. Okay, we're going to do that so he doesn't look so angry. We will leave his eyebrows. What am I doing? Glasses. And he was wearing those super round glasses. Not these. I don't know which. Oh, here. He was wearing these ones. And you guys love them. So, yeah, we're totally giving them to him. I think we're going to do these ones. So, yeah, it just gave him this, like, quirky look. And I will be changing his clothes to, like, kind of, like, quirky clothing, I guess. Because you guys really liked that. And I really liked it too. So I think for his hair, just for now, we'll just like, I don't know. What should we do that? That's like a quirky hair. Because I don't want to like mess around with his hair right now. But I feel like he needs something different to kind of go along with his look. I don't know. I'm so happy he came though. Oh my god, that is so him. Like it looks a little funny, but like isn't it him? It so is. Maybe we'll give him that. It's all about the character. So that's what, like, yep. Okay, and you know what? We'll change his shirt. How about that? But we won't do anything else. Because, like, this is fine. Well, is he wearing... Oh, he is wearing girl jeans. I mean, these are for both. But I personally prefer if he's in these. So we're going to give him those. And then we'll just quickly. This might change so quickly. Gotta hurry. We'll give him, like, some shirt that would like match his personality more, like this one, I feel like would. Yeah, definitely. Maybe just like in the gray. Okay. So I'm maybe changing that to something even more like quirky looking. But that's what we're gonna do for now. I don't want to like stay in there forever. Yeah. Alrighty. So there he is. Alright, so she is she's in her disguise again. Also, if you guys want to see like their different outfits and stuff that is in the makeover video as well, just for anyone who's wondering. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and do a deep conversation. Let's unpause. We're gonna go ahead and tell an engaging story. We are going to brighten day, and then let's go ahead and do some things. So we're gonna go ahead and like flirt with him. She is so obsessed with him, you guys. Like, she never thought she would meet a guy like this, just at prom. And it's so funny that she met him at prom, never like even noticed him at school. And yeah, that was like a big deal for her. Look how cute. See, those glasses like totally suit his personality. I love it. I don't even know what his personality is, actually. Okay, he's clumsy. Oh, clumsy and genius, you guys. That's perfect. Did I know that? And I totally forgot that I knew that, because I feel like I never checked that. And that is perfect. We're gonna compliment his outfit. We're gonna go ahead and compliment his appearance. And then they're not gonna do that yet. We're gonna do a pickup line. Also, you guys probably know the apartment we're in, but we're over here. And then, you know, it's the one with the ones with the balconies, which I'm really happy about. And then out in the front here, I'm so happy we have this, because when they have kids in the future, they might have their first kid when they're still in this apartment, because you guys want Allie to get pregnant quickly, and I do too. I feel like she would. That's another thing with her story, is she, obviously, she's never, oh, that's another thing too. First of all, she wants to get in touch with her mom. Why do they keep eating this fruitcake when they hate it? No, no, no. We're gonna joke about old times, but yeah, as I was saying, she wants to finally get to know her mom. That's a big part of season 4. She never wanted to in the past. She was scared to. She was scared to find out who her mom is. She knows her, but has never spoken to her, so she knows who she is. Where is she? Right here. But she can chat with her and send texts, and she will be doing that, probably in part 2. She's gonna, you know, she found out her mom's number, and she's gonna go ahead and call her for the first time ever. And she really had no interest in this when she was a teen or a child. She honestly, she just wanted Destiny to be her mom figure, and she loved Destiny so much. She still loves Destiny so much. Destiny is going to be visiting a lot, that's one thing for sure. And yeah, so she's ready to communicate with her mother, so that's going to be happening. And then another thing is, the reason she wants to start a family so quickly, and she's so obsessed with him, she feels like he's perfect and everything, and she just can't wait to see what the future holds, is because her dad didn't turn out how he should have, you know, or who she thought he was. It was not good. And she didn't really have a father, really. He wasn't around. Aww. And, yeah, and so she didn't really have a father, and then never met her real mother, and then she just had Destiny, which she's so blessed to have had her. So blessed that Destiny even moved to Willow Creek, moved the whole family right away to Willow Creek when they were broke because aliens were banned in Newcrest. So yeah, she did that for her. She just has so much, she just loves Destiny so much, and she's so grateful for her. I think he's leaving. What is all this? But yeah, she wants to start a family of her own so quickly because she wants to be the best mom she can be, and she wants to have a beautiful family and not have the family break up. And she's so hoping Dylan is the one, because then her son or daughter will have an amazing father, and she'll just be able to have the family she always wanted. So that's kind of why she wants to move quickly in life, and she's so excited. But yeah, she is having very different feelings about life right now. And yeah, she's gonna be getting a treadmill. I'm kind of thinking maybe she found it at the flea market, and maybe she'll bring it home in the next part. I think that would be really cool. So yeah, I think I am gonna actually go ahead and end this part here, guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed the first part. I know not much happened, but I'm so glad that Dylan came over, and you know, I got to explain everything and not have it be the entire part, because the first time I tried this, I would have been talking for the entire part. Like, no gameplay at all. That wouldn't have been good. I know there was a lot of talking, but in the next part, it's going to go back to normal, just like the normal Foster Family Let's Play. But I'm so excited to see what the season holds. I hope you guys are excited. Like always, you guys can leave suggestions down below. If you guys don't know, I do comment of the day for this series. So you guys can comment things down below, and in the next part, I'll be doing comment of the day, but I just couldn't for this one because it's the first episode of season 4. So yeah, I'm so excited, you guys. We're going to be getting more into their career in the next part. And yeah, so like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys are all having an amazing, amazing day. And don't forget to leave some positivity down below. I love you guys all so, so much. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.